Sunday Night Live with Bob Jackson and Fiona Williams, live and exclusive to Liver Radio, is proudly sponsored by the Liverpool Actors Studio in Seal Street, here in the heart of Liverpool.
Smooth, suave, sophisticated. And he's a DJ too.
Under the circumstances, anything could happen in the next half hour.
This DJ can keep it up all night long.
I dare you to say that again.
This DJ can keep it up all night long.
Broadcasting from the heart of Liverpool and to the rest of the world, you're listening to Bob Jackson and Fiona Williams on Liver Radio.
midnight hour is close at hand. Creatures crawl in search of blood to terrorize your neighborhood. And whosoever shall be found without the soul for getting down must stand and face the hounds of hell and rot inside a corpse's shell.
I'm gonna bring it to life.
Stenches in the air, the funk of 40,000 years, and grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. And though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil of the thriller.
Broadcasting from the heart of Liverpool and to the rest of the world, you're listening to Bob Jackson and Fiona Williams on Liver Radio.
Two of a kind, for your information, we're two of a kind.
Two of a kind, it's my observation, we're two of a kind.
Like peas in a pod
and birds of a feather, alone or together you'll find that we are two of a kind.
You're listening to Sunday with Bob Jackson and Fiona Williams here on Liver Radio, broadcasting from the heart of Liverpool.
And it is from the heart of Liverpool. I'm going to say good evening to everybody that's in our chat room, and a big good evening to you, Fiona. Hi, Fiona.
Hello. Gosh, you're being very formal tonight. Robert.
I'm trying to contain myself. I'm so excited I could crush it.
Gosh, there's a lot of people in there tonight.
There is, for good reasons, because I think they're going to be a little bit taken aback like I was. But first and foremost, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to introduce to you a lovely lady that's going to help us along with proceedings tonight in the first hour. And I'm going to say a big hello to June Field, a lady with amazing talents. Good evening, June.
Hello there, Bob. Hello, Liverpool as well.
You've got a lovely accent.
So have you.
They
remind me of the Beatles.
Hang on.
Don't get him to sing them.
Hang on. There's one that I don't like. Which one do I sound like?
You sound like them all. You sound like Paul McCartney. Do you look like him as well?
No, he likes McCartney. It's just the drummer he's not so keen on.
Yes. He gets on me nerves the way he talks about Liverpool all the time. He never says a good word about South City.
Brilliant, that's a good accent, well done.
Once again, I'm going to say a big hello to everybody in the chat room. Mrs. Google, I can't mention everybody by name because I need to be somewhere in a couple of minutes and you'll understand why. I'll explain everything. In the meantime, we're going to have somebody called Ava with us right after this.
Tonight, don't love me, 'cause I'm not.
Shalamar, hoping this is going to be a night to remember, and I've got a feeling it will be a night to remember for different reasons. On the line now, I have a well-known lady who's known as Ava for the time being. Ava, good evening. How are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
I'm very well. I'm a bit hot at the moment, and I know you need to be going somewhere soon, so I'm going to throw you straight over to June Field. June, would you like to say hello to Ava and give her one of your...
Hello, Ava, how are you doing?
I'm fine, how are you, June?
I'm very well, thank you. I did listen to you say hello, and I'm right into your energy as we speak. I'd like to first go to describe your character. You're a very determined lady. You're also very stubborn. You take no nonsense. It's a black and white scenario with you. It's either right or it's wrong. There's no grey area with you. You're also a very loyal individual. You keep close friends close. There are lots of acquaintances, but you keep the same close friends close. Just when I linked into your energy, I was aware of a lady who I'd want to put above you that passed with a cancerous condition, and she just pushed straight into my energy. And I know that this lady would either be mother or grandmother, but when I say that, I'm talking about that you would have been close to her in life, and she would have had a lot to do with your upbringing, and she just pushed straight in. I'm also looking at a black gravestone with gold writing on it. I don't know whose that would be, but I'm looking at it. And I've got the hymn How Great Thou Art being sung in the background. Does that mean anything to you?
What did you say? Sorry, I've got the what?
The song, it's my accent, that's what it'll be. The Scottish accent.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. The song How Great Thou Art. It's a hymn, and I'm hearing it singing in the...
Oh, yeah, I know it, yes, yeah.
But does it mean anything to you? Was it either played at a funeral, or was it someone's favourite song?
Not really, no, but I'm a Catholic, so I know it.
You do know it, okay. But when I go in your energy, I do feel that you have to juggle a lot of things in the air. If I took your watch from you would be totally lost. If you need to look at your watch, you have to be here, there, everywhere. You tend to not delegate very much, my dear. You tend to just do it all yourself, because I don't feel that you think that anyone does it up to your standard, because you have a very high standard. You like things to be in order. You like things to be totally in your order, and also done your way. And if they're not done your way, it upsets you. So I think that's where you go to, you know what, I'd be just as well doing it myself. And that's that. And you are... I'm looking in and around my home, and I'm one of these tidy freaks. I like things to be in their place and everything, you know, to be just so. And I feel that you are that way also, that you like things to be in their place. And also, I see suitcases around you, so I don't know if you're always going away and back and away and back, but it's as if I'm like a woman in a suitcase, living and travelling back and forward. And it gets to the stage where I don't feel that you actually unpack the case. I think that you just leave it to the side. There's no point in putting it away. It's actually meaning myself as well. I have one behind the door that doesn't go in the loft. It sits here because I'm away and back as well.
Yeah.
I'm also aware of a gentleman that is coming forward from spirit side of life that I would want to connect with you. And I have to say that I would have wanted to say father figure. And I feel that you would have been a daddy's girl or connected to this father figure that you thought the world of. And I feel that you pushy individual in any way, shape or form. He was someone who was just live and let live and live your dream. He didn't speak about anyone either. He was someone who, if you mentioned about people, he'd say, well, you know, maybe it's because of this, or maybe they're like that because of that. He would just allow people to get on with their lives. And I don't actually feel that he did manage to say what he would have wanted to say prior to his passing over to the other side, because I feel that he went very quickly at the end. And I also feel that I don't feel that everyone was around him when he passed. There were people missing. Mm. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. with yourself, when I look at the energy that I've got surrounding me, because how it works with me when I hear your voice or when I connect with energies, it's as if I'm plugging myself into a piece of electricity. I'm also pulled in and around the stomach area with yourself, so I feel you have to watch what you eat. But in that sense, I feel you're your own worst enemy, because it's like I get a catch-22 and I get myself uptight and worried about things because I want to make sure that everything is just right. I want to go to the right leg as well. Do you have problems with your knee?
Not at the moment, no.
Who in your vibration or around you has problems with the right knee?
Yeah,
you understand?
It'd be my dad,
Yeah, I'm picking up right in and around the right knee area, and it's someone who's got to be very close to you and just close in your vibration. And I do feel that there is a real bond with this individual, someone that you just totally think the world of. And there's not a lot of people that you actually do think the world of, that there's mistakes and you're you like things just right. There's no room for mishaps. There's no room for mistakes, and I don't mean this in an unkind way, but you could be quite judgmental that someone does something and it's like, right, that's it, I'm done, because I just won't bother with it. And that's the way that you are in life. You just cut and dry, you separate the wheat from the chaff, but I feel that this gentleman would do no wrong in your eyes. Can I also go in and around your stomach, or just above the stomach and hip area? Do you either have a scar or a tattoo or a mark?
No, no.
Does the gentleman we're talking about have a...
I'm not sure, to be honest.
Okay, right. Well,
I'm
just
sorry.
October, November time for you, I feel that there is an opportunity coming, and that it's actually going to just put you right out of your comfort zone. A little bit of a hurdle, but I've got a big tick of approval with it. You suss things out really carefully, and if you're not sure of something, you will kind of just wait. You don't tread on thin ice. You need to make sure that it's just okay. And I'm being told that you need to grab this with both hands, and at first it will push you out of your comfort zone, but it will allow you to grow, because you play safe a lot of the time. You like to do what you know.
Yeah.
And you need to be grabbing this with both hands, my dear. So
okay.
I wish you all the very best with that. I'm also seeing a
window
below you. Do you have a son?
A what?
Do you have a son?
No.
Okay. You're not pregnant?
No.
Okay, I'm still aware of a younger male, a male energy that I'm seeing that's either young or just pushed forward, but you will succeed in what you do, but you need to step out of your comfort zone, which is not what you really like doing, but this will allow you to grow, and by the time it comes to the springtime next year, you will be looking at things with another string to your bow and from a totally different viewpoint. Do you understand that?
Yeah, I do.
Good.
Ava,
well, I wish you all the best.
I do.
Even with the bit...
Thank you, June.
I know about
you. You're very welcome.
Thank you.
But was June in the ballpark there a couple of times?
Yeah, she was, actually,
Yeah, very good. Yeah, so did I. June, I'm going to give you a little clue as to who you're talking to. And just bear with me now, okay? You're actually talking to Claire Sweeney from Brookside and many other programmes.
Oh, Claire.
Hi, June. You all right, love?
I'm fine. Yeah. Thank you very much. You're also a good singer, aren't you?
I enjoy singing.
I think she is,
Fantastic. Oh, well, I'll tell you.
Well,
there
thank
is
you
a
for that reason. Oh, that's great.
Thank you very much. You will do very well with it.
Claire, can we tell people?
Thank you.
Can we tell people why why you're getting the train and where you're going to be tomorrow?
I'm just going down to London. I'm on this morning tomorrow.
Ladies and gentlemen, Claire Sweeney is on this morning tomorrow, and she's found time to fit us in, getting the train. And I want to say a massive thanks for fitting us in, Claire. I don't know how you've done it, but thanks a million.
It's an absolute pleasure. I'm at the train station, as you can hear, so...
I heard one or two...
A bit noisy. Trying to find a quiet place in the station.
But did you enjoy that, Claire?
What's that?
Did you enjoy that? Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, I said it was great. It was a really good reading. Yeah, really, really good. She's great.
Thanks very much, Claire.
Really
and if you want to record another, let me know. Not a problem.
Thanks, June. Okay,
thank
you.
Nice talking to you, honey. Bye-bye.
Take Claire.
Okay, thank you. Bye.
Take care. Bye. Take care, bye. Claire. Bye-bye. That's not easy to say. Ta-da, my love. Bye. Bye.
Yeah.
Yes, Things in Life Are Free by the late Luther Vandross. We're having this special psychic night. Hello to everybody in the chat room tonight and outside the chat room. We've got a chocker room tonight and everybody listening outside, and it's rather exciting. I want to say thanks to Claire Sweeney for taking the time. Don't forget, she's on this morning. She's getting the train as we speak to Houston, because she's going to be on this morning. And now we've got another big name with us, and his name is Paul. I'm going to say hello, Paul.
Good evening to you.
How are you, sir?
All very well, thank you.
Good to hear.
Looking forward to this very much.
So am I, because we've just had some good stuff just going on about 5 minutes ago. Excellent. So I'm going to pass you over to June Field.
Okay, hi June.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm very good, thank you.
The way that it works with me is when I hear your voice, I tap into your energy. And right. I must say that as a gentleman, as I'm speaking to you, you're actually quite sensitive for a male. Please don't take that the wrong way.
I'll take that the right way.
They seem to focus on one thing at a time and can only do one thing. You're actually one of the few that is quite compassionate and caring and is able to multitask. Now, I do want to go in and around your vibration, and I feel as if I have been through real turbulent times. When I get the colour black and white, it means that you have really been on an emotional roller coaster and be gutted like a fish on an emotional level at one point in your life, and you've actually started to build yourself back up from that. It's as if you've had a dunt and you're doing very well, but it's like you've reinvented yourself. It's as if you were sensitive and a bit, I don't want to say the word gullible, but I just mean as if you were a bit vulnerable, and now I just feel as if you're actually starting to cash in on the happiness and actually the security without feeling that insecure feeling of where am I going, what am I doing next. I feel as well that you would have, you know, lived one way, travelled somewhere else, done this, done that, but now I feel that you actually want to just settle, and that's the feel I have for you. Does that make sense to you?
I've done a lot of travelling. Continue to do that. It depends what you mean by settle, I suppose.
Well, just settled within yourself. You've actually found yourself, and you're actually feeling a lot more settled than you ever have done within your life. I feel as if I'm more secure within who I am as a person. This is going to sound very strange, but I've just seen something blow up. Was that an electrical fault or a microphone or something that ever blew up while you were either in the vicinity or had it in your hand or done something like that?
I've had it a few times, yes.
Yeah, because it's something I don't normally get, but I've just seen something that's just blow up, or it's just made a loud noise and lots of sparks and bangs. And can I go in and around yourself? Do you have thyroid problems?
Do I have thyroid? Not that I know of, no.
Okay, because I'm just up and down. I have a dryness of the mouth. And when I get dryness of the mouth, it's either overactive or underactive thyroid. That's just the way that... Sorry?
I've heard of thyroid problems, but I'm not really aware of what they are.
Okay, just to feel as if we've got a dryness of the mouth with yourself.
Right.
I'm also aware of a lady that has just pulled in behind me. And I know that she is connected to you in spirit side. I would be wanting to put her above you. But more so, I have a gentleman that is pulling into the side of me. And I know that he passed very quickly and very suddenly. One minute here and the next minute not. That would be the nature of his passing. I don't know if it was accidental or if something happened. I am pulled in and around the chest area with him. And I just feel that he was just gone in an instant. And I am hearing singing as well. I feel as if I'd be wanting everyone to just come together and harmonise. And I can see musical notes also. So there's musical notes written above your head, so you must be able to read music. So it's crotchets, quavers, minims, breves, semibreves. It's not just the listening, but it's the music.
Yeah.
I'm getting listening, and I can see you actually writing it down on manuscript paper as well. And it's as if it's not very far from you that you always seem to want to jot something down. You're not very far from a piece of paper. You don't sleep that well at night either. Join my world. I'm not a great sleeper myself these last few days, but it's as if, I think that's when you get your best ideas, is just, you know, things mill around in your head in the evening time. You are a nice guy. I feel very settled in your vibration. I just feel as if you would be very honest, even although it would cut someone to the quick, you would be totally honest. They know that they would get an honest opinion from you. If they ask you something, does my bum look big in this? Well, yes, it looks enormous. But at least they know that they could trust that opinion from you. You must also suffer from back problems. Do you have sore back? Do you, between the shoulder blades?
Well, yeah. I suppose you could say sort of slight neck tension things, yes.
Okay. And I want to go right down one leg, please. So I don't know if you either have problems with your quads, or if you get cramp, or if it would have been the remainder of a sciatic nerve, or something of that point, but I just want to go down the one leg with yourself.
Right. Well, no, nothing that I'm aware of. I mean, I've had slight neck problems which were connected to nerve endings, but nothing that went into my legs, no.
Okay. Well, I just still feel in and around the back, and it just goes right up the back of the neck. But more, should I say, one side than the other. It's
right.
As if I'm imbalanced with it. But with you, and what's coming in the future, is that there is something new, something that you're opening up to that I don't feel that you have attempted before, and it's as if I have a whole new format or a new schedule. It's as if I've got an athlete that would have been fabulous at running, but now they're going to try swimming, but they're still an athlete. That's what I'm trying to say. It's as if you, in the business that you're in, are still going to remain in that business. But there is definitely a new string to your bow, and I can see the energy of you that's moving to the side and off at a tangent, and it's as if, again, one step forward, half a step back. Will I? Won't I? Will I do it now? Will I not? And I know that you do all your thinking at night, that it's, you mill everything round in your head, you get it in some sort of order, and I do know that by next year that it will be up and running. I'm also seeing a guitar for whatever reason. They've just shown me that. It's just been put out in front of me, so I don't know if you've bought a new one or if you have one or if something's happening, but it's like I've got a new string to your bow. And it actually will be successful, but for some strange reason, I feel that this would be the second time that you've either thought about it or attempted it, that I feel you're more confident now to attempt it. You have one foot much bigger than the other. Now, don't take that the wrong way. That's just...
no, I think I'm told, or I've heard that almost everyone does a little bit, but not that, not that it's noticeable.
Okay, because I'm just told to the right foot. Is there problems with the right foot? Do you have athlete's foot, bunions, anything?
No.
I'm just pulled to the right foot with you, Nick. I'm just seeing that stepping forward, so it's as if you're going to be stepping onto new ground, and...
Right.
It's opening something up for you, but again, I'm seeing the foot step out and actually put itself down very firmly on the ground. So this time, there's no faltering. I feel that you will be moving forward with it. I'm pulled to the teeth area as well. There's got to be problems at the back teeth, either sensitivity, or you've either missed a filling, or there's something not quite right in the back teeth.
Right.
And?
I'd say that's true.
Because I just that, and I tell you as well, it's the right hand side of your mouth, and I would want to go more to the top than I would the bottom.
Okay. I'll get it checked out immediately.
No, you don't have to get it checked out. Your teeth are not going to fall out. It's just my way of connecting with you. And you are very sensitive as well. Do you have a glass in your hand at the moment?
I did, yes, right then.
Yes, because I'm just seeing
right then, that second.
Yes, I just saw you pick up a glass, and you had a glass in your hand. I want to just wish you all the very best and say cheers to you, because you have been through a lot of turbulence within your life. You as a person have become more secure within yourself and what you want and who you are, and it's actually going to benefit you within the next couple of years, especially when you step out at a tangent with this new project or new venture, because it's going to be very successful for you. Okay.
That's great to hear. Thank you very much, June.
Right.
You're very welcome.
June, would you like a clue? Yes. Would you like a clue as to who you've just been talking to?
I definitely would.
Any ideas? It's the one and only Mr. Owen Paul.
Oh my God.
Good evening.
Owen, how are you doing?
I'm very well doing. Thank you very much for that. That was great.
Thank you very much for being a guinea pig and just putting up with me there. But it's nice. You definitely are starting a new venture, because just I can see it moving. So that's for sure. And I wish you
that's good news. Thank you.
Oh, brilliant, Owen. Thank you.
And you were bang on when you said I picked up a glass.
Yes.
That was weird. That was weird.
In a millisecond.
Right.
If I'd have heard it, I would have heard it in my cans. I would have heard it in my headphones. I didn't hear a thing.
Okay.
Yeah.
No.
So was you happy with
it? No, thing.
So was that a good reading for you then, Owen?
Very good. Very good, mate. And actually, I do have a new project coming, which I'm sure we'll talk about, with a woman you know called Debbie Curtis.
Oh, yes, very well. Yeah.
She does a thing, radio big bands, swing stuff.
Yeah.
And I got involved. I've just recorded a track with her for a charity called Viva. It's like fighting against cruelty to animals and such. But that's not the main thing. She's asked me to record a new album with her of swing classics and take it out on tour.
Oh, how
which
wonderful.
Which I've never done before, and I'm looking forward to doing.
Oh, you're going to come back and tell us all about it, though, aren't you?
I would love to, Bob.
Oh, and you're a top man. Thanks for joining us tonight.
Absolute pleasure.
Thanks, Owen, and the best of luck,
Owen.
And talk to you soon.
Thanks, June.
Sit down, mate.
Thank
bye.
You. Take care. Bye bye.
Okay.
Bye.
Thanks, Owen. Bye, mate. Top Loader and Dancing in the Moonlight. And I want to say a massive thanks to Owen Paul and of course Claire Sweeney, who is on this morning in the morning. She's getting the train now as we speak. But now we've got another well known name, but for the time being, we're going to call her Betty. Hi, Betty.
Hiya.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So am I. I'm a little bit warm in the studio, so I'm going to cool off a little bit now, and I'm going to hand you over now to June Field. June, say hello to Betty.
Ooh, exciting.
Hiya, Betty.
Hiya. You all right, June?
I'm all right. How are you doing? You good?
I'm very good, thank you. Just relaxing, yeah.
Good, good. You know, the minute I heard your voice, I felt very emotional, as if I want to burst into tears.
Oh.
So I know that there has been a lot of emotion ups and downs within your life. You seem to be an emotional fixer. It's as if there's been, you're standing in the emotional firing line and fixing everyone else. and that is you're
that's
juggling
true.
All the plates in the air, as if to say, oh my gosh, you know. And it doesn't seem to be all your stuff. You're fixing everyone else's.
That's true.
And I'm also, I want to say happy birthday for May. Was there a birthday celebration in May?
Sorry, in May?
In May, yes.
In May, yes. Well, I've got a massive family.
Yes.
Birthdays
so
all
I'm
the
just,
time.
I'm just, you have been through a lot of emotion within your life, but it's made you strong. And you remind me a little bit like the proverbial swan on the top of the water. You look as if you're in total control of everything, that no one sees the feet underneath going like anything to keep you in a set direction.
And that's a good analogy.
When it comes to your problems and your emotions, you're not as great at fixing them as you are other people's.
No, that's absolutely true.
You are an absolutely fantastic fixer, and people draw to you like moths around a light, and they dump the problems in your lap because of it. And you know, you could even be sitting somewhere, and even in a queue, or sitting somewhere where you haven't met a particular person or you don't know them, and before you know it, they'll have given you all their problems, or they'd have shared a lot of confidences with you.
Yeah.
And it's just because you're of sensitive nature. You're a very caring individual. You really love animals. I feel as if I want to have a good rapport with you with animals, in particular dogs. I don't know if you have had lots of dogs or if there is one in particular that's buried in the garden.
Oh, I've got my little dog Snowy.
Yes, without a doubt. And I'm just aware of animals around you. I think that you would do a lot for good causes with the animals as well. I'm also seeing as if I've got words written out in front of you, and I'm doing the same thing over and over and over again. So I don't know if what you do in work makes you either be a character or do the same thing time and time again, or just... It's like, I've had Claire Sweeney on earlier, and I know that she was out of Brookside and she was a character, but I just feel as if I'm doing the same thing over again with you. I have boxes packed around you as well, so to me, that means that you're either in a move, or you're either decorating, or you're having a reshuffle now.
That's funny, because my sister's just come to me tonight and said, she just brought a load of boxes in and said, I'm moving out of the place with my boyfriend, I'm going to buy my own place. She brought a load of boxes round tonight.
There's definitely a move afoot, but it's not happening yet.
No.
It's as if everything's pending and everything needs to be settled down. Now, you mentioned sister there, and you're just like chalk and cheese. You are totally different energies, because just whenever you mentioned her, it was just, woof, I just felt as if a total different energy. I feel that you... Again, proverbial swan, you're the one that likes to try and keep her on the straight and narrow. She could be a little bit insecure with things, and that she likes confirmation and validation that she's doing the right thing, and that's why she knocks on your door. Now, that is just exactly what I was saying about people dropping their problems in your lap. But you're a great fixer. You have this incredible...
Oh, yeah, my house is fixed central.
But you do have a knack of fixing other people's problems, and you're actually a bit sensitive yourself. I would want to go right far back to when you were small, and I feel that you were of sensitive nature, that although you could be surrounded by lots of people, you still felt as if that you were just that little bit different, or they could be having a fabulous time, you think, I'm having a nice time, but I don't seem to be having as nice a time as they are.
Yeah.
And are you into angel things? Do you like angel things? Now, I don't have a lot of angel things in my home.
Angels?
Yes. Do
I
like
believe
angels?
In them?
Well,
I've got a little angel that my mum gave me that I keep.
Okay,
yeah.
That's fine, yeah. That it would be kept close to you or kept near, or it is just, I feel, more sentimental value than worth anything.
Yeah.
But I'm pulled in and around that too. And your family seem to be all scattered in quite a lot of different directions.
Yeah, they are, yeah.
I don't feel as if I could go down the road and have a cup of tea with someone. I feel as if I'd have to travel one way to see someone, the other way to see someone else.
Well, it's a big family. We're all spread over the place. I mean, there's three sisters all in one area, and then there's other sisters and brothers in other parts of the country.
I'm hearing "Oh Danny Boy" being sung. Does that mean anything to you?
Sorry, Danny Boy? Oh, yes. Danny Boy, that one.
Yes, yes.
My dad used to sing it, a joke version of it.
Okay, as in like the pub singer.
Yeah, that Jenny B.
Yes, exactly, on a heel far away. That type, but I'm just hearing that being sung in the background. And I have to say that I've also got quite a lot of people in spirit gathering that are claiming to be family members, but it's not all through blood. Is there any fostering adoption or half-brothers and sisters somewhere, please?
Yes, there is.
Yeah, because they have to be. They're not the same colour of energy as what I'm feeling from you, but they are still claiming to be family. And do you have a brown and white dog?
A what, love?
A brown and white dog.
No, my dog's called Snowy. She's white.
Did you ever have a brown and white dog?
Yeah, I used to have a dog when I was a little girl called Basil. He was brown
and
white. Yeah.
Now, was it a Jack Russell or a Cocker Spaniel?
No, it was a mongrel, but probably had a bit of Cocker Spaniel in it.
Okay, because it's not a big dog, it's not small either, but...
No, just medium, yeah.
Yes, and it's brown and white, because...
Do you know, Basil, you know how old that dog was when he died? He was 21.
17. Was he 21?
21. Can you believe
that? Gracious. Well, I say, your work's cut out for you, my dear. I'd like to say, oh my gosh, everything's going to be fabulous, perfect. You know, you will continue.
Can you tell me something
this.
About my love life, please?
Well,
I need one.
If I give you your love life, what I see for you as an individual is.
Is there anybody nice? Is there anybody nice out there for me?
I'm here.
There are nice people.
Get off, Bob.
You're a bit fussy. You have.
I'm very
you
fussy.
Have standards, and your friends will say to you, "Listen, that guy was okay. No, he wasn't because he did this." You get hung up on people that have got habits of some sort, and then before you know where you are, they're all blown out of proportion.
Mm.
So it's not for the lack of people approaching you; it's that you just cut them down.
I'm very fussy, yeah.
Very, very fussy. Even if they've got spelling mistakes or there's something.
But do you feel that is there anybody out there? Because I'm quite happy on my own at the moment.
There's nothing for you coming this year or next, but I can't see you on your own for the rest of your life.
No.
But I feel that there is a lot in family or a lot of things that are going around emotionally, family-wise, that need to settle and need to be sorted.
Oh, they do. You're absolutely right.
You are the matriarch of the family, or you're the sorter outer. And
I am the matriarch, that's absolutely right, yeah.
And so you need to be available to sort all this out, and once it is all sorted out, they're also making mention of a younger male on this side of life who either had problems with either dyslexia, slight dyslexia, or turning things around or something.
Well,
do you understand?
Yes, that's interesting, yeah.
Yes.
Yes,
so
I have a relative who has that, yeah.
Don't tell me anymore. Just, I know that there has been a little bit of upheaval with regard to him, or a little bit of, I'm getting a tick of approval, and I know that he will find his 40 and that everything will be okay, because there's been slight worry in that direction.
Mm.
So with you won't be on your own for the rest of your life, but you've got a wee bit more sorting out to do, because that seems to be your job here, and you're blooming good at it. Can I say that to you? So, I'm going to leave your love very much with you, okay?
So,
okay, thank you, June.
So we've just been talking Betty, June. Betty joined the cast of Crossroads, playing the part of a pop singer who was recording a single in a fictional motel basement recording studio, and the song she sung was this, and then went on to have a hit with it. It's the one and only. was a stonker of a song. That was it. I've got goose pimples because it's one of them moments.
I've been talking to you, and lots of what you said is very resonant with me. Very, very interesting indeed. Thank you.
Did it?
Thank
you. So a hit song for you, Kate?
Yeah.
You've got a lovely voice.
Thank you. But it's funny because I'm doing more comedy now. I'm doing Grumpy Old Women tour with Jenny Eclair because I do comedy now more than music. But it's interesting you're saying about saying the same lines over and over again. I'm learning a massive part at the moment. So yes, that's what that is.
You will be repeating.
Repeating, yeah. You have to learn the lines, you know, yeah.
Well, if you
want, brilliant. Thank you very much.
And I wish you the best, June. Thank you.
If you want a copy of this, Kate, just give me a shout and I'll send you a bit.
Thank you, darling. I'm going to listen to it on the internet anyway.
All right, my love. Thanks for your time, Kate. You take care.
Bye, love.
Bye. They have Whiskey in a Jar by Thin Lizzy, and our thanks once again to Kate Robbins, lovely lady as our Kate, and of course thanks to Claire Sweeney, and not forgetting Owen Paul. Right, on the line now we're talking to Rosa Varchak. Good evening, Rosa.
Good evening.
Good evening, Rosa. I'm going to pass you over to June Field to have a little chat.
Okay.
Hi, Rosa.
Hello there. How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing? Good?
I am very well.
Yeah, well, just with listening to you speak, that obviously gives me a connection with yourself. And with you, I feel as if I'm all over the place, as if I have a decision to make, or as if I've got to make my mind up with something. It's as if I'm looking at lots of pieces of paper on the floor, and I have to decide something, and I'm a bit undecided about things, which to me is not really what normally happens within your character, because I feel as if you are a very good judge of character, but I do feel that you've got a sensitive side to you. You used to wear your heart on your sleeve a lot of the time, but experience has made you a bit stronger and a bit harder with things, and now you decide what you want, and you don't go either way. You're just, it's got to be right down the line. It's like, no, this is what I want. Now, I'm pulled to the stomach area as well with yourself. Have you been having problems with your stomach, whether it be a tummy flu or anything at all?
Yeah, I had a bit of a stomach ache, yeah.
Yeah.
Wasn't sure what it was.
Okay, but I'm just pulled in the stomach area. I just feel as if I've got sensitivity that way. I'm also pulled to the right shoulder and up the neck area with you. So I don't know if you've had problems or if you've had a stiffness or something's not quite right in that area with you too. And you must. Do you suffer from migraine headaches?
Not really. No, not too bad, no.
No, I'm pulled to the head as if I'm on overload. I'm having to think of a million things, and you remind me of myself.
Yeah, I was in the middle of a building construction situation where there was like builders and plumbers, and yes, that water came up 2 days ago.
Oh, well, I know that you either gave them what for, and you said, no, this is what's going to be happening, because it's, I just feel as if I'm juggling everything in the air with yourself. And for some strange reason, I see you standing alone a lot of the time. So I don't know if you spend a lot of time by yourself or as if you don't let a lot of people in, but it's as if, you know, I feel as if I'm quite lonely, although I don't feel as if you've not got people around you. I just mean that I feel as if you stand alone with decisions or having to do things. I just get that. As if I've got to keep everything in here and keep control of the reins, and I have a gentleman that's in spirit that's coming forward, and he's just poured a drink for me, and it's as if to say that he's holding up a glass for a congratulations. So I don't know if you've just achieved something, or something's just happened where there is a celebration coming off, or there's one that has just come off, but it's as if he's holding up a glass to say, thank goodness we've just gotten through that. Does that make sense to you? Hello?
She's gone.
Rosa?
No, I'm still here.
You still there, Rosa?
Hello?
Hang on, June. Hang on, this is live radio, and this is what happens on live radio. Just give us a minute. Here, we should have her back any time now.
Oh, sorry, I've got pretty bad signal here.
I can hear you now, Rosa. I'll hand you back to June.
I'm in a very remote place.
Okay.
Okay.
So, don't move. Stay where you are.
Stay where you are now. Okay. This sounds great.
Stay where you are. That's cutting the flow. You're testing me to my limits now, cutting off and on. And it's as if I feel that you stand alone and you're at the helm all the time with things. And I feel as if you need a little bit of a break. A little bit of a hug, a little bit of a hey, you're doing the right thing, you're doing great, but I don't feel that you get that. I don't feel the camaraderie of family around you supporting you. Would that be right, Rosa?
Yeah.
And it's just like, oh my gosh, the buck stops here with me. I've just seen the Statue of Liberty. Are you not in the United States, are you?
I'm in California right now, yeah.
Yeah, because with the ringtone, etc., but all the ringtones that are abroad sound the same, but I know that it's got to be the USA, because that's my sign, is the Statue of Liberty. I'm seeing you there. And do you have problems with your ear as well? Because I've just gotten a pain in my ear, so either you suffer from sinus, or you've had an ear infection, or there's ear problems. Just one ear.
Oh, I've always got something going on in my ears.
Yeah.
Whether it's blocked.
Either you get a draft, or that there's just a slight pain in them.
Mm-hmm.
As well, but, you, as an individual, I feel quite tired with you. I feel quite depleted. I do feel as if you're going through some sort of emotional trauma at this particular, or should I say an adjustment, but I'm not worried about it, because you will get what you want at the end result, because you don't settle for anything less. And that is a strong individual that just says, listen, that's not what I asked for. This is what I asked for, and I don't want that. I want this. So you will end up getting it. And this is going to sound very strange, but did you ever live near where there were sheep, or on a farm, or did you ever have a baby sheep or a wee lamb for a pet, or do you have a soft toy sheep or lamb?
Well, I'm living in a place where they've got pigs, and I did recently meet a sheep, and I'm from the New Forest, so there's lots of sheep and pigs and animals and things. And my friend, I have pet goats, but my good friend had pets when I was growing up, so we used to look after the goats.
Right, okay, but I just see as if I just want to connect you with a sheep at this particular time as well.
Yeah.
Now, can I ask, do you suffer from sinus problems, my dear?
I do, yeah, I do generally, yeah. My ears or nose, or, you know, I have to go to the ENT sometimes, you know, to check out my ears.
Do you know, the feel that I have with you is that I want to tell everyone to just go away and leave me alone, because I need my space. And it's very strong. I feel it saying, get the heck out of my face. I just need, give me some space and don't bother me with incidental.
Well, I have to be honest with you. I've been waking up to plumbers, but literally wake up and there's a tape measure going through across the bedroom. You know, it's like, electricians, there's plumbers, there's builders, there's everything. But that's just in life. But in general, that there are a lot of people, there are a lot of people around. And it's difficult to get space. Yeah.
Have you just recently got a new tattoo, or is there a change in a tattoo, or are you getting one?
I've got two of them. I've had it since I was 15, and it was really stupid, and I really want to get it covered up.
Okay, I know there's going to be a procedure with either a tattoo or something to do with the tattoo, or it's going to be changed, or it's going to be made into something else. And it's funny, because I'm also handing you a butterfly. Does that mean anything to you?
Well, I see butterflies here a lot. I see them in the morning, and they're really beautiful, and they always think, oh, it's nice, because, you know, it's nice to be able to sit and notice them.
Well, the butterfly,
yellow one.
And they're handing it to you, and it means that you are on a change from one thing to the next, like the caterpillar and chrysalis to the butterfly, where the wings expand. And that, to me, is where you're heading. You're not quite there yet, my dear. There's a little bit more of expansion to go, but you're nearly made it. You're nearly there. You're just on the cusp. So I wish you all the very best. Do not make the batteries go right down until there's nothing left of them. Keep some charge in your batteries. You keep going until you drop. Don't do that. But, you know, there's big things to come for you. I'm going to leave the love with you.
Right, I'm going to give you a clue.
Thank you.
June, I'm going to give you a clue who you've just been talking to, and I know I'm just like over the moon, and my listeners will totally understand why I'm over the moon. Just have a listen to this. You're actually talking, or been talking, to Sarah Joyce, better known as Rumi.
Oh my gosh, you know, I just watched you on the TV the other day. Isn't that, in fact, you were on just the other night. Yeah, hello to you.
Winston.
What a fantastic voice you have.
She
thank you.
She has.
Everyone seems to want a piece of you, so, Rumi. Don't allow that.
Oh, bless you. Bless mm-hmm. you for saying that.
Yeah.
I'm in recovery. I'm in recovery right now. That's why I've got...
You're in recovery.
I'm living with his sheep and stuff. Well, no sheep, but just pigs and
rumor.
Animals and things.
You're in recovery.
You'll be okay. You will be fine. Just look after yourself. God bless you, my dear. You've got a lovely talent.
Thank you.
Lovely voice.
Rumor.
Oh, thank you very much.
Thank you so much for coming on tonight.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
And at this moment in time, I'll just tell our listeners where you are. You're actually in LA, and you're taking the time out to come on our little show tonight. And we thank you from Live Radio.
It's quite funny, Bob, because there's no signal here. I mean, it's too rustic, so I'm actually sitting under a tree. I mean, it's quite funny. I've got the phone hanging onto a branch.
There's got to be a song there somewhere, surely.
Going out.
But Ruben, yeah. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
From the bottom of my heart, because my listeners know how much I put you up there, and I'm not blowing smoke because I don't do that. But I put you up there with Karen Carpenter, Dusty Springfield, and you're in there. I'm sorry. I just love your voice, and millions of others do too. And thanks once again. Thank you.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Thank you.
You take care.
Thank you. Bye.
Talk to you soon. Bye bye now. Bye bye. Bye bye. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Rumour. June, yes. Tonight, I don't know who you've spoken to in your world, but even in my world, tonight has been a little bit crazy. you've managed to speak to Kate Robbins, Claire Sweeney, Owen Paul, and international superstar Rumour.
Fantastic.
How do you feel yourself?
I feel I've been connecting with a lot of lovely souls, a lot of talented people, but also a lot of people with sensitive natures and very strong characters. I get my connection when the people are strong, my connection is stronger. So I want to thank you very much, you and Fiona, for allowing me and giving me the opportunity to connect with them.
Well, I've just had a lovely message on my Facebook from another clairvoyant, and she thinks you're doing and I thought that was very gracious of her, and she said you're doing a wonderful job.
Oh, that was lovely.
I thought, I was listening because I know some of these people, and I know bits of them and about them, and even I was getting goose pimples. So, well, ladies and gentlemen, this lady was a little bit nervous about coming on tonight because she doesn't normally do this. She normally does it face to face. Well done, June, and from me and Fiona and our listeners, we want to say a massive thank you to you as well.
Oh, bless you. Thank you very much. My pleasure. Anytime.
Thanks, June. You take care, and hopefully one day we could do it again.
Without a doubt, Bob. Take care.
Take care, June. Thanks, my love. Bye-bye.
Take care. Lots of love.
Bye-bye.
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 Oh, ladies and gentlemen, the last one we just spoken to there was Zoom, and everyone knows I'm just in love with the woman. There, I said it. It's out there. And I can hear Kath now running off now to the solicitors. So coming up now, we've got to move along with this show because we've only got not long left, so we've got to start moving. We've just been talking to Rumour. I've got to play this big gender quiz is coming.
You make me want to sing about love.
Slow this ride.
Sing about love.